This is Associate Pastor Joe Wood of Pleasant Hill Baptist Church giving you Sunday night, April 26, 2020's podcast. Last time I shared a message, I spoke on the subject of a servant's heart in unfavorable times. Jesus Christ, in his unfavorable circumstances, became a servant and washed the feet of the disciples, displaying the ultimate example of servanthood. Well, tonight, I would like to share a message that has been a challenge to myself, and I pray that it will be for you. Go with me to 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18, and we'll go there and read that as well right now. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18, and I want us to actually back up to verse 15, and we'll read actually from 15 down through 22. The Word of God says, "See that none render evil for evil unto any man, but ever follow that which is good, both among yourselves and to all men. Rejoice evermore, pray without ceasing, and everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Quench not the spirit, despise not prophesying, prove all things, hold fast that which is good, abstain from all appearance of evil." Now, in chapter 5 of 1 Thessalonians, under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, Paul is writing to the church here at Thessalonica on the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ and how men should be living his or her life. If a person truly believes that Jesus Christ is coming back, which I do, and if you're a Christian, you should as well, the way that he lives his life should be changed as we knew what our command from the Lord is. We should be sharing his word, living out his word, and celebrating the truths of his word in our lives. The way that we behave toward others will change. In verses 12 and 13 of 1 Thessalonians 5, we see that our attitude will change toward the leaders of our church. In verses 14 and 15, the attitude toward our church family will change. And then we get down to verses 15 through 22, and we see that our personal attitude will change in every aspect of our life. And so in the time that I have with you tonight, I would like to share a simple message entitled, "A Thankful Heart in Troubled Times." A thankful heart in troubled times. And in this message, I would like for us to consider a few questions. As we focus on verse 18 of our passage here, in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18, it says once again, "In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God, in Christ Jesus concerning you." So the first question I'd like to ask us tonight is, what was he commanding them to do in verse 18? What was he commanding them to do? Well, it says in the first part of verse 18, the command is, "In everything give thanks." So Paul was writing to us here to say, "In everything give thanks." If you look up the original Greek word for everything, you will find that it is governed by the preposition "in," basically saying without a noun following. It signifies in every matter or condition. So one could say, "In every matter, give thanks," or "In every condition, give thanks." My question to you tonight is, I wonder how much we have been thanking the Lord during this pandemic. You know, a couple weeks ago in Sunday school class, I asked the question, what has God been teaching you through this pandemic? Well, one thing that was brought up was that one said, they have learned for every negative thing they say or they read to say three things that they are thankful for. So for every one thing negative, they say three things that they are thankful for. If you're like me, you get caught up in all the negative things that are being talked about, all the questions that are being asked without having an answer to, and I can easily get wrapped up in all of these things without focusing on the things that I should, and that is praising God even in these troubled times. But the second question I'd like for us to ask, when we think about the main question is, what was Paul commanding them to do? What are the things that we should be thankful for? Well, I want us to understand that we have so much to be thankful for. And these are just five or six simple things, very fundamental and educational things that we should be thankful for. And I just want to share these with you at this time. During this pandemic, first off, we should be thankful that God is our Father. If you and I are Christians tonight, we've accepted Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. We have a Father in heaven, and that is God, God Creator. And we need to magnify Him for who He is. In Psalms chapter 69, if you would go with me to Psalms chapter 69, when we think about magnifying God, we first need to think about magnifying for who He is. It says in Psalm chapter 69, verse 30, it says, "I will praise the name of God with a song and will magnify Him with thanksgiving." But not only should we magnify Him for who He is, but secondly, we should magnify for His wondrous works. In Psalm 75, verse 1, it says, "Unto Thee, O God, we give thanks. Unto Thee do we give thanks, for that Thy name is near, Thy wondrous works declare." So we should be thanking Him for His wondrous works. And then finally, we should magnify Him for His unspeakable gift. In 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 15, it tells us, "Thanks be unto God for His unspeakable gift." So you and I should be thankful that we have a God in heaven that is worthy of our praise, that is worthy that we need to thank Him for daily, and we need to magnify Him for who He is, His wondrous works, and His unspeakable gifts. But secondly, the second thing I want us to be thankful for is our health. Now, I know there are a lot of people that are not healthy, but our health should be one of the first things that we should be thankful for each and every day. There are a lot of people in society today that are not able to watch this live stream because of what is going on. There are a lot of families sitting by a bedside praying and asking God to do a miracle in their family's life. Every day that the Lord gives you breath, you should sit up in the morning and say, "Thank you, Lord, that you have given me another day to see your wonderful creation." Thirdly, not only should we be thankful for God for our help, but thirdly, we should be thankful for our homes. Now, I believe this is one thing that you and I have been taking for granted, and that is the home that we live in. Through this pandemic, God has showed me just how grateful I am to live in a home that is warm in the winter, cold in the summer, and a place that I can feel at peace. Home is where the family is at. I have been more thankful for my wife in these last few months than I ever have, given my surgery and now this pandemic. We have grown closer together and have spent more time with one another as we have been blessed with it. Like someone stated, one thing that they have learned through this pandemic is just how important the home really is, and we should be thankful for it. Then fourthly, it's our jobs. Now, I know a lot of you, even in our church family, are laid off right now, and you don't have a job. But it is one thing that I'm thankful for. I'm thankful for the wonderful place that God has given me, the wonderful position that God has blessed me with. And you and I, as we go through this pandemic, if you are working or if you're not working, you should still thank God for the job that you have or will be getting back, or the job that whatever, however you want to say it. But we should be thankful for how God has gifted us and gave us the careers that we have and the money that is blessed through that, and we are able to put food on our tables through our jobs. And then fifthly, we should be thankful for our church. And in three ways we should be thankful for our church. First, we should thank Him that we have a wonderful place to meet. Oh, how I miss the wonderful place that we get to call our church building. But you and I know the church building does not make up the church, but the people inside the church make it up. And we have rallied together and have been worshiping in our homes together as families. The Word of God may be preached in different ways right now, but let me tell you something. It is spreading throughout the land in a way that we may not have ever been able to do. Because of this pandemic, people are listening to Facebook Lives. People are watching YouTube, and they are hearing the gospel more probably now than they ever have before. People that would never have went into a church building are listening to the gospel message being preached all throughout social media because of this pandemic. And so for that, I am thankful for how God is using His Word to spread throughout the land. But then secondly, we need to be thankful for our pastor. As we're thankful for our church, we're not only thankful for the church building, the church people, and we need to be thankful for our pastor. If you didn't thank the Lord for our pastor before, you definitely should now. The heart, the compassion, the burden that he has for you and I is unmatched. The hours that he spends studying, reading, meditating, and praying for God's will is what I am thankful for. No message is just by coincidental or convenient for him. It is prayed down from heaven and is inspired by the Holy Spirit of God. And I'm thankful for a pastor that even in this time is working diligently, trying his best to be the shepherd that he is for his sheep. And then finally, as we think about being thankful for our church, we need to be thankful for our church family. If there is anyone that I miss, it is definitely my church family. I miss your smiles, your kind words, your loving hearts, and tender voices every day. And I long to see us all once again. But during this time, God has revealed to me just how much we need one another and has given me a deeper love than I ever have had before for my church family. And I hope He has for you as well. When we do finally get to meet again, it will be a wonderful reunion like we never have seen before. I even believe that the ones that couldn't get along before will even get along. I'm just picking. But simply put, it will be very, very sweet. And then finally, the last thing that we need to be thankful for, not only for God our Father, not only for the health that we have, the jobs that we have, the church that we have, but finally for the Lord Jesus Christ. And in that, there are many things that we need to be thankful for the Lord Jesus Christ, for His ever-abiding presence. As you see in the Great Commission, the Word of God teaches us to go, but He also says as we go, the Lord Jesus Christ will be there with us. In every situation, He will be there with us through it all. And so we need to be first thankful for His ever-abiding presence, His presence in the good and the bad. I will be honest, I don't understand how people are going through this pandemic without the presence of God in their life. Jesus Christ's presence never wavers. He is with us when we are hurting. He is with us when we are on the mountains. The presence of Him becomes so real when we need Him. He separates all of the bad and gives way to the positives. If you are fighting anxiety today, the presence of Christ is in your life. Allow Him to guide you through the rough days. For someone that has dealt with anxiety in recent months, I now have a deeper sympathy for those individuals, because it is a rough place to be in. But at the same time, during my time of depression, I have found the presence of God to be sweeter and sweeter. And so I am very grateful and thankful for the ever-abiding presence in the good and the bad from our Lord Jesus Christ. But secondly, not only for His ever-abiding presence, but secondly, we need to be thankful for His holiness. In Psalm chapter 30, verse 4. In Psalm chapter 30, verse 4, go with me there. It says, sing unto the Lord, O ye saints, all of His, and give thanks at the remembrance of His holiness. We need to be thankful for the Lord Jesus Christ and His holiness, and thirdly, for His mercy and grace. As you and I know, mercy is God giving us something that we did not deserve, that we deserve. God not giving us what we deserve. And then finally, we need to be thankful that His mercy endureth forever. And Psalm 107, verse 1, it says, Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy, praise God, endureth forever. Praise be unto God that his mercy endureth forever, and we need to be thankful for that. We need to be thankful for his love, the love that is sweeter than any love. And finally, the love that is never ending. Praise be unto him for his love that he has for you and I. Because of his love that he has for you and I, he is with us through all of this pandemic. He is with us during all the trials and tribulations that we are going through the temptations that we're going through. His presence in our lives is because he loves you and I. If you don't think that anybody loves you today, I want you to know, go to 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 1 through 8, and you will find the love that Jesus Christ has for you. It is a sacrificial, substitutionary love that he has for you. And then finally, because of his love, we need to be thankful for the cross at Calvary. Listen to me. We can never thank the Lord enough for the sacrifice that he made for you and I. Because of his love, because of the love that he had for you and I, he went to the cross of Calvary, died a death that he did not deserve, died for you and I on the cross of Calvary, and resurrected on the third day for you and I, so that we could have a relationship with him. And because of that relationship that you and I have with him through the power and the presence of Christ in our lives, as we've accepted in him as our Lord and Savior, we have hope, joy, peace, even in these troubled times, even in these uncertain times. We have that hope and peace that there is coming a day that this too shall pass. I don't know when that day will come. I don't know how it will be, but I do know that this too shall pass from you and I. It may be that Jesus Christ, God our Father, heals our land, or it may be the second coming of Christ, that Jesus raptures his church. And if that is true, we never have to worry about this pandemic anymore. We'll never have to worry about any troubled times anymore or any uncertain times, because we'll be in the presence of Jesus Christ. We'll be in the presence of perfection, and we no longer will have to worry about sickness or anything like that because of what Jesus Christ done on the cross of Calvary. And so you and I, every day of our lives, should be thankful for the cross of Calvary, should be thankful for the resurrection of Jesus Christ, should be thankful for the love of Jesus Christ, should be thankful for his mercy and grace, should be thankful for his holiness, and should be thankful for his ever-abiding presence. If we thanked him every day, it still will not be enough. But listen, these are some simple things that we need to be thanking the Lord daily as we go. And so we have seen a few questions that we've asked. The first question that I ask you is, what was he commanding them to do? And then secondly, we ask the question, what should we be thankful for? Well, then finally, I want to very quickly give you one more question. Why was he commanding them to do these things? Well, if you read in verse 18, it says, "In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you." Simply put, this is the will of God, God the Father, for your life. You are to praise the Lord, your God, in every circumstance. His plan for your life is far greater than you can ever imagine. For you to live out your life the way God would have you to, you live a life that is thankful even when the times get rough. The will of God is pictured for you in verses 15 through 22 in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. And as you read them, you can see God's plan for your life is to be centered on him and him alone. Are you in the will of God in your life? If there has ever been a time in your life that you need to be in his will, as we see the day of Jesus Christ rapturing his church approaching, it is now. So my challenge to you is to find and be in the will of God in your life. Well, finally, the last question I want to ask you is this. How does one thank the Lord? Well, very quickly, three things. We continually give thanks. It is through our daily lives. As we have mentioned throughout this lesson, the Bible tells us clearly to give thanks in all things. So that means throughout your day, you are giving thanks unto the Father for what he has done. Not only that, but it's through song. I know this is one that some don't think they can do. However, as the Bible commands us to do, we are to give ourselves over in song. This means that we are to make a joyful noise. Now, Not one person can say they can't make a joyful noise, because truly a joyful noise is defined in how you approach worship and praise. If you are praising the Lord from your heart, then you are making a joyful noise, because there is joy in the one that you are praising. And then finally, not only through your daily lives and through song, but then finally, thirdly, through your prayer life. As you pray daily, thank the Lord for everything He has given you. That means the things that I have already mentioned and the things that come to your mind. In Philippians chapter 4, verse 6, it says, "Be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God." In conclusion, or in closing, my question to you would be this. How much have you been thanking the Lord during this pandemic? In your daily life, are you thanking Him for His presence, His love, His promises, and His peace that He gives us? In everything, give thanks. That literally means in every situation, whether they be good or bad, give thanks unto the Lord. I hope and pray as you stay home and listen to this podcast this week, when you hear or say something negative, you will say three things that you are thankful for, and each time they have to be something different. May God's word challenge and sustain you until we meet again. God bless you.